they now become the favorites to win the NFC East. Don't you agree?
Yeah, absolutely. I think they got. I think they have. They may have the best roster in the league. The whole thing now. The big question about the Eagles is the quarterback, right? Like, is Jalen Hurts the guy? If he goes out there and he doesn't perform well, there's no excuse for him. He's had every weapon he possibly could have, and he had every possible opportunity. So to me, like, I think of it as a win-win. If he goes out and he plays great, good. We got a quarterback. If he doesn't, then there's not going to be no issue or no questions about, well, we didn't get him enough help. We didn't do this. No, we know. You're either the guy or you're not the guy, and we can go from there. But whoever they bring in is got, I mean, they got a great offense. They got weapons all over the place.
All right, guys, I've been waiting to get to my boys here. Hey, by the way, if you have any questions for Philly 500, we bring them on now. Dude, I'm going to say, hey, Philly. Dude, blew my mind last night. Dude, it blew my mind last night. They get the guy I wanted in Jordan Davis.
Me too.
Then I said this yesterday. I said, look, the 18th pick's going to be in play. I heard they tried to move it to Green Bay to trade down and get someone. Mm-hmm. Instead, they were having a dual-track plan, Philly, where they were talking with the 49ers on Debo, and then they landed on AJ. Before I even do any other thing, let me get your response and your reaction first and foremost on how you saw the Eagle draft last night play out.
I thought it was the greatest draft I can remember the Eagles had in the first round. I thought it went perfect. Jordan Davis is a guy that I've been talking about pretty much all offseason. Like, I thought they needed to get him, and I thought he was most likely. Just knowing how the Eagles valued the defensive line, it just made a lot of sense. The A.J. Brown thing was something that I've done videos. We've talked about, like, going out and getting a veteran wide receiver, but I never thought they would do it. So, like, I was streaming live, and, like, people were, like, saying A.J. Brown. I thought they were just bullshitting me. You know, I didn't believe it. So, to me, it was shocking, but it just makes so much sense to me, you know? And I got to say, you know, Easy Money, he loves Matt Corral. So, to troll him, I got this jersey to wear, this Matt Corral jersey. But I forgot that A.J. Brown went to the same school. Went to the same school. So I now feel like this is the luck charm. I have to wear it now because I think this is the reason why we landed A.J. Brown. The jersey.
How about this, Philly? So here's now the official offseason. Hassan Reddick, 3 years, $45 million. You got a guy who's going to get you double-digit sacks now. You restructure the contract so that you could maybe make this move to get A.J. Brown with Fletcher to get $4 million more off that books and pay him $14 million. You get depth now with Zach Pascal, okay? Yeah. He's not going to be a frontline guy. Right. He's going to be depth on the team. You make that trade so you can maneuver yourself around in the other rounds because you were under the impression you may land one of these veteran wide receivers.
Mm-hmm.
Then you sign a player in Jordan Davis who everyone – and I said this yesterday too, Philly. There were probably around 14 true first-rounders in this draft. The rest of them, in my opinion, were between the 15th pick and the 16th pick. I think they were pretty much all the same. Mm-hmm. I think they were all second- and third-round guys. So if you really reach too high, you could overdraft easily in this draft.
Yeah.
So – They get a guy who's a legitimate first-round guy. You're going to have the biggest defensive tackle tandem, like, in NFL history now. I can't think of any other tandem that maybe the Haynesworth guys when they had that with the Titans. But then you land A.J. Brown. I mean, they now become the favorites to win the NFC East. Don't you agree?
Yeah, absolutely. I think they may have the best roster – in the league. The whole thing now, the big question about the Eagles is the quarterback, right? Like, is Jalen Hurts the guy? If he goes out there and he doesn't perform well, there's no excuse for him. He's had every weapon he possibly could have, and he had every possible opportunity. So to me, like, I think of it as a win-win. If he goes out and he plays great, good. We got a quarterback. If he doesn't, then there's not going to be no issue or no questions about, well, we didn't get him enough help. We didn't do this. No, we know you're either the guy or you're not the guy, and we can go from there. But whoever they bring in they got a great offense. They got weapons all over the place.
I'd say this to you too. You and I were both under the same, I think, we were under the same umbrella here when we said, they're just not helping this kid.
Right.
Now there's no excuses, right?
Right.
Right. And that, yeah. Now he's under the same pressure that Tagovailoa's under in Miami. And I would even Absolutely. Say this to you too, Philly. Look at what they did in Arizona. They get Hollywood Brown. They add him to that mix out there on the other side of DeAndre Hopkins. Now you get Zach Ertz out there. You got a bunch of dudes out there that can move the chains.
Yeah.
You know, this is what the new wave is now. And you got to look at how we doing this. I got two number ones next year where I could parlay into maybe either getting the kid from Ohio State, maybe Bryce Young, or the kid from Miami, Tyler Van Dyke. If this kid doesn't pan out, do you agree? We've got to see something like 4,200 yards and 25 touchdowns for them to go like this. Okay, here are the keys to the house.
I was going to say 30 touchdowns, but maybe 25 to 30.
How about 25 and 7? Like 25 touchdowns, 7 picks, 10 picks, somewhere in there.
I think so. I mean, I think so. And you know, they've given him every weapon possible. I mean, you look at A.J. Brown, Devontae Smith, Dallas Goedert, Miles Sanders, the running back. They're loaded, and they got the best. That's the best offensive line in football, arguably, right? So, I mean, I don't see any excuse, and I think it's going to be a lot easier for them to evaluate Jalen Hurts now, right?
Yeah.
So I mean, I'm good with it. And then if they decide, hey, look, he's not the guy, whoever comes in is coming into a team ready to go, you know?
You know, Xander and I were talking about this prior to going on the air. Do you think they'll know by week 8 of 2022 if he's the guy?
Yes. Yes, I think so. I think by week 8, if we haven't seen dramatic improvement, I think that we know what we got. I would say so. What I'm curious about is how much are they going to change up their offense? Like, are they going to still be as run heavy? Or are they going to back off? Are they going to back off running him more and let him throw more? Like, are they going to put more on him and his arm and try to really see what he has, you know, put him under that pressure? That's what I want to see what they do, you know?
The impact you think A.J. Brown has on Devontae Smith?
It's got to be huge, right? They needed a veteran-type wide receiver. And not only are you getting a veteran wide receiver, you're getting a stud veteran wide receiver, Pro Bowl-caliber veteran wide receiver. So I think it has a huge impact. It's got to be huge.
It's got to be huge. And I'll say this to you too, 500. I don't think – Philly, I don't think that they have to run the ball 38 times. I think what they have to be is productive per carry. Like for play action for these guys. Look, you're spending $100 million not to bring in a guy where he only gets 5 targets a game.
Right.
The financial commitment is not for him to come in and try to change his game. The financial commitment. And you know why he even fits more this mode? Think about where he comes from. Dude, he was the centerpiece. He was not the centerpiece on that Titans team.
No.
The centerpiece was Derrick Henry.
Yeah.
So he's coming in knowing this. The centerpiece on the Eagles is running the ball. I was in the same almost system. The only difference is the quarterback's more responsible for the rushing attack than what we have with Ryan Tannehill. So he's almost coming into this. I say also, too, he has to improve the run game, though, because he's a beast blocking down the field.
Right. Yeah. I mean, it was dramatic.
Have you been any more excited about the draft than what you saw last night?
No, I didn't sleep at all last
round.
Night. What was that?
Or at least the first day.
I think this is probably the most excited first day I can remember. Because they basically took the defensive lineman I wanted. And then they did something that I talked all season about trade that 18th pick for DK, Debo, or AJ Brown. Whoever will take the trade, call all of them. And I'm like, they'll never do that. They'll never do that. And they did it. So, I mean, it's the most excited I've been in a long time. I don't know, man. It sucks that, like, football's not starting next week. You got to wait, like, 4 months. You know what I mean?
I have
a question for you, man, because you played defensive line. Like, you know, what are your thoughts? Like, how do you feel about Jordan Davis when you look at him and what he can be, his upside? Because I get a lot of people saying, oh, he's going to be lazy like Albert Haynesworth because of his weight, or his weight's going to be a big issue. Like, what are your thoughts about him?
My only issue with Jordan has been this. He had 19 and a half tackles for losses and 43 starts at Georgia. Mm-hmm. There were times when they took him off the field on third down so that they could get into different pass rushing schemes, and he wasn't really part of that. And I would say this to you. Why wasn't a guy who runs a 4-7-1 part of your pass rushing scheme? Now, you're also on a defensive line where three guys went in the first round. Five guys went total off that team. So sometimes stats could be convoluted in a scenario like that,
right,
because you have so many good football players that are on that football team. I think if they use him right and they use him correctly, put him in a one gap, man. Don't just make him a slug there on the nose. Let him get penetration. That's what he did at Georgia. Don't let him sit on the line of scrimmage. That's what Fletcher bitched about last year. Let those two horses run.
Run.
Let them get into gaps. And if they're able to do that, I think they have somebody special. But what I will tell you this, though, Philly, here's something, though. Let's hypothetically just say this. Let's say that Jordan Davis turns out to be Vince Wilfork for a second. Okay. Let's say he turns out to be Vince. He's not the perennial pass rusher that we maybe predicted he might not be. Like, is he a 10-sack guy? I don't think he is. However, doesn't this go back to the days of the 2017 group where you had the top O-line and the top D-line? How would you like to have the top rushing offense in the NFL and the top run-stopping defensive line in the NFL?
Oh, yeah.
If you've got that tandem again, that puts you in every single freaking game you're going to be in, no matter what. Because you know why? You may lose a game, but you're not going to lose the fight. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Well, that's – I think the worst is Vince Wilfork. Maybe the best could be like a Neil Smith, who played for the Kansas City Chiefs.
Yeah, I remember Neil Smith,
perennial Pro Bowler.
Well, I mean, you can't go wrong with either. I mean, Wilfork played what, 12 years or something? I mean, he had a long
career. Super Bowl championships in England.
Yeah, so I mean, I'm not going to complain about that. You know.
So I'm saying his floor's Vince.
Yeah.
Okay, so I mean, I'm not saying his floor's somebody else. Now, here, let me ask you a couple more questions here. Where do you think that leaves Hargrave?
My guess is, if I have to guess, Fletcher Cox goes and they try to extend Hargrave a couple years. I think – because I think Hargrave's a better pass-rushing defensive tackle.
So does Jordan Davis start this year, or does he play I think
Fletcher Cox starts and he rotates in, and then I think at the end of the season, Fletcher Cox goes, they keep Hargrave, and then they start Jordan Davis that next year.
They got a lot of money in Hargrave.
Yeah, they do. They do. And you know,
he can't put him on the bench over there on the right.
But, I
was thinking about Philly, how they were going to do this rotation. Okay? You draft a kid high. Now, he's going to have to rotate in. And again, if we're talking about first and second down, hopefully he's able to stay on the field on third down and he's able to rush, but you got another guy. Both these defensive tackles that the Eagles have, you got a lot of money tied up in them.
They do. They do. I mean, I think you know, the Eagles should probably look at it like a year to be mentored by Fletcher Cox. I mean, mentor this kid, Fletcher Cox, let him work behind him. And then, you know, next year when Fletcher Cox goes, give him that starting job. Hargrave was having a fantastic year. If you remember,
was.
I think he had like 9 sacks.
He did.
And then what they started doing is they started double teaming Hargrave and not Fletcher Cox. Well, if Jordan Davis taking those double teams, all of a sudden Hargrave's going to eat because he's going to get single coverage again. So I think that's how I would approach it, you know.
What do you do with Milton Williams?
I just let him keep developing. I mean, he's a rookie under a rookie contract. He can't be that much. Just keep him. Let him learn. If he earns playing time, great. You know, I still think they need a defensive end, though.
Look at how this defensive line is now all of a sudden completely different here. Reddick, yeah, Davis, totally Hargrave, Sweat. Yeah. I mean, you're this is a group like the 17 group. Like, you know, I mean,
yeah.
The Eagles' remedy and secret to success that year, dude. I don't know how many times I said it. That's the best tandem that I've seen since the Steeler teams back in the 70s. Mm. They were just killing teams. Here, let me give you what he says here. If Hurts goes down and Minshew brings them to the playoffs, then what? Evaluate Hurts in 2023.
No, I think you move on from Hurts.
Yes.
You know, I think you have to move on because you got to decide extension. If he gets hurt, you know, what, week four, week five, and he wasn't that great, yeah, I think you move on.
That'd be the second injury in 2 years, too.
Yeah, yeah. And I do worry about him getting banged up because he runs so much. That's always a concern. So, I would let him. He has to go out and he has to play good. He has to play good, and he's got to be healthy. That's all part of the same thing, I think, you know.
Day two, what do you want to see the Eagles do?
I want David Ojabo. I know that's a risky pick.
You're going to add another guy to the D-line? It's already crowded, that room.
I know, but I'm going to lose Derek. I'm going to lose probably – well, Derek Burnett stinks. I'm going to lose him a year. But then I'm going to lose Brandon Graham the year after. And I still think you need another edge rusher. I think that kid is raw, but I think if he develops – I think he could be one of the best pass rusher in this draft. So I would take a chance on him. I don't think N'Kobe Dean will be there. The other guy I really like is that Booth Jr. kid, the corner. So I would not mind him or that safety Brisker. I think the Eagles are going to go either corner, safety, linebacker, defensive end.
Drake Jackson out there from the US, that linebacker kid who could play in a 34 and 43.
Yeah. Yeah, that would be perfect. I mean, I'm just thinking about Howie Vision. He took Landon Dickerson in the second, injured. He took Sidney Jones in the second, injured. These were guys that should have been top 15 picks. David Ojabo is kind of similar. So it just would not surprise me. I'm not saying they're going to do it. I'm just saying it wouldn't surprise me.
Philly, Mrs. Hurts is in here again. Jalen, will you put that – or Xander, will you put that up, please? Hurts' injury was due to a teammate stepping on his ankle, not from
not running.
He's durable.
Oh, I think he's durable, no question about it. But I don't want them to put him in situations where he's running so much that he could get hurt, or, you know, worn up, banged up too much. I think that's something that I don't want to see happen.
I would say this to you, and with Mrs. Hurts in the room here, Philly, we agree. Jalen is now given the tools to succeed.
It's all him. Absolutely.
The group that he had prior to that, Mrs. Hurts, no disrespect, he was not going to be given a fair opportunity like Tagovailoa is in Miami. Now, you invest $100 million in the development of Jalen Hurts. You're giving this kid every opportunity to succeed with a line. And you've got a guy you drafted in the first round, the former Heisman Trophy winner, who broke Eagle records. You got maybe the best. Would we agree this is the best tandem of wide receivers the Eagles have ever had?
It could be, yeah. I would say so. Because I think they're both legit number one wide receivers. So, yeah, it could be. Yeah, I mean, I'm thinking back Mike Quick, Chris Carter, but Chris Carter wasn't really Chris Carter at that point. You know, it was
maybe
kind of
Mike
before.
Quick and maybe Carmichael, if you want to go back that far. I don't think Jackson Macklin.
No.
Because I've said this about DeSean Jackson numerous times. I think he was a one-trick pony. Okay, I think he was a deep threat. I don't think he was a really great route runner. I just don't.
Yeah.
How about this, too? Would you agree that this defensive tackle tandem here maybe the best that the Eagles have had since Jerome Brown and Reggie White?
Yeah, has the potential. However, that's still the greatest defensive line. Yeah. I can't. Jerome Brown,
hey, listen, I bumped Keith Jackson and Keith Byers for you and LB today.
Oh, yeah? Oh, man.
Keith Byers and Keith Jackson are coming on. And by the way, Beasley Reese is a dear friend of mine. He's coming on next week, too.
Ah, man, I grew up on that team, man. I was so heartbroken when Keith Jackson left when
He went to Miami, right?
Yeah, I think he went to Miami. And then he went to Green Bay after that. But man, I loved Keith Jackson.
You gotta promise me, man. You'll post it on my Twitter. You've got to show me a reaction at you when you saw that draft with the Eagles. I would have paid money to watch you come unglued, man. Because here was my reaction. Holy shit. Are you kidding me? I can't believe what they've done. They got the guy I wanted, and then they made a trade for a vet.
Yeah, I know.
Awesome stuff, absolutely, man. Hey.
But I mean, like you said, man, we've talked about this. The whole thing was to do right by Jaden, get talent around him, and let him go out and play. And they did it. So I can't wait, man. I think he's gonna have a good year. It's gonna be fun.
Philly, thank you so much, dude.
Gobble-ghoul time, man. Gobble-ghoul time.
Gobble-ghoul time. Mean? Thank you, my brother. Thank you very much. You know what I got to ask? Miss Hurts, you know the Philadelphia Eagles contact me now every single week now. And, they follow me now. And they text me, what do you think now? I'd like to know what you think. What do you think of what they did on the opening day? I still think that they got some work to do here. But you've got to be proud of what the Eagles did for your son. Okay? You just got to be. Lord Brunson's going to be with us in hour number two. We're going to get another perspective. Also, LB will be with us. Hey, I'd love to have Mrs. Hurts on. I was really legitimately happy that Jalen's going to be given a true chance. I said it right here. There's no way he can succeed with the guys that he had on Wednesday night. Now, he's got every opportunity, okay? Guys, when will we know? When will the Eagles know if Jalen Hurts gets a contract extension? I want to hit on that. Don't forget also, Morgan & Morgan, where the fee is free. Means this, guys. When you're searching for an attorney, it's one of the most important things that you could possibly have happen to you and your family. Finding that attorney is important. And guess what? Size matters. Morgan & Morgan's the biggest law firm in the country, and this is what they do. For the people is not a slogan, okay? It's who they are, and it is what they do. For the last 30 years, Morgan & Morgan has collected in compensation for their clients $13 billion. Think of that for a minute. They go to battle for you, making sure your family gets the fair compensation you so rightly deserve, and other companies try to cheat you out of. Not going to happen at Morgan & Morgan. With over 800 attorneys in offices in Philadelphia, New York, Florida, and across the country, the army of attorneys with Morgan & Morgan will do battle for you each and every single day, making sure you get that fair compensation. Look, the call's free, the compensation's right there for you to understand it. It will be in your hands. And that consultation's free. Call them at 800-512-1600. That's 800-512-1600. No attorney firm like it in the country, Morgan & Morgan. And do me a favor. When you call them, tell them Big Sil sent you.
When choosing a lawyer for your injury case, you may ask, does the size of the law firm matter? Well, of course it does. The insurance company, they're huge with unlimited resources. And whether your case is big or small, they're built to bully you out of the money you're owed. But here's the good news. We're big too, the biggest actually. And we're built to bite to make them pay for all that was taken from you. Size is our strength. There's only one Morgan & Morgan, ForThePeople.com.